Hello and welcome back to Travel in Chinese. I'm Mark Rosewell, also known as Dash N. Through this series and through the dialogues that we're following in this series, we're talking about traveling in China, but we're learning language that can be used in a wide variety of everyday situations. Xue Mei and Huang Renhao have made a friend in Lijiang. Although not a native of the area, this person has lived there for 20 years and so should be considered a Lijiang Tong, an expert on Lijiang. Tong is short for Jing Tong, to be skilled or knowledgeable about something. For example, 中国通, a China hand, somebody who knows a lot about China. Lijiang Tong is an expert on Lijiang. Here's a good example of the sentence pattern 凡是 something, 都是 something else. 凡是你喜欢吃的, 我都喜欢. I like whatever you like to eat. In this dialogue, Xue Mei goes on to notice the interesting clothing worn by the local Naxi minority women. Her friend goes on to explain that the cape worn by the local women has a special design on it. 七个圆形的图案, a design with 7 round shapes. These represent 七颗星, 7 stars. The white is heaven, the black represents earth. So this shawl is also known as 披星戴月, to hold the stars and moon on your shoulders. It's a symbol of the hard-working nature of the people here. 是纳西族女人辛勤劳动的象征. It's a symbol of the hard-working Naxi women. Okay, let's take a look at that video.
你是在这里出生的吗？不是，不过我很小的时候就到这儿来了。好，那你啊也算是丽江通了。不敢当，有没有想吃些什么？我想吃丽江粑粑，那一定是丽江的特产吧。哎，你刚来丽江，知道的还挺多的。不过我们一般都把它当早饭吃。
那除了这个，丽江有没有什么特色菜？您可以推荐推荐。
浙江饭馆就是丽江特色餐厅，凡是菜不上的菜都是丽江特色菜，像这个鸡豌豆粉、乳饼什么的，都挺好吃。服务员，点菜。好。好，谢谢。
你这么好看的衣服，这是哪一个民族的？
是纳西族妇女的服饰。那你怎么还戴这个围圈呢？
哦，这不是围裙，这是不是雷布份。对，而且这些围裙大多是黑色、白色和蓝色的。结婚前后围裙的颜色也不一样。
哎，
小帽，我听说纳西族的女人非常能干。
还真是这样，这里的女人格外能干。
是。
哎，你猜猜，她衣服的后面是什么？
那是一块披肩吧？对，这块披肩上有七个圆形的图案，你们猜像什么？哎呀，还真看不出来。那是七颗星，而它的头饰代表的则是月亮。
听起来很有意思。
不仅图案有意思，不同的颜色也不同的含义。
哦，是吗？
对，你们看，这个披肩上白色代表天，黑色代表地，这个披肩。
和这个头饰合在一起，被称作披星戴月。披星戴月，那表示纳西族妇女每天早出晚归，劳动很辛苦。所以这套衣服也可以看作是纳西族妇女辛勤劳动的象征。
Huang Renhao has been looking forward to hearing the traditional music of the Naxi people, 纳西古乐. He's heard that many people are very moved by the music. 被他所感动. In the next lesson, we reviewed the use of 被 before to put a verb in the passive voice. Here, it's a verb-object pattern in the passive voice. 被他所 plus a verb. To have been, verb, by something. 被他所感动, to be emotionally moved by something. We learned a bit more about this music. 原来是一种道教音乐. Originally, it was a Taoist form of music. 道教 is Taoism, a traditional Chinese philosophy. Unlike Buddhism, 佛教, which originally came from India, Taoism originated in central China. So what is it doing here in Yunnan, in the southwest of China? Well, it was brought here from the Central Plains area, that's the traditional heartland of China, hundreds of years ago. It combined with traditional folk music here to make what we now call 纳西古乐. This traditional Taoist music is hard to find elsewhere in China. 反倒在丽江地区一直流传下来. But it has been passed down in the Lijiang area. Fan Dao indicates that the following statement is counterintuitive. It's not what you might have expected. Lijiang is far from central China, yet the music survived here. That's unexpected. But it's thanks to the Naxi people that 这种古老的音乐才得以保存下来。This ancient music has been preserved. Now, by adding 才 to this sentence, it indicates that otherwise the music would not have survived. This was the only way. 得以 literally means to achieve, that the endeavor was successful. 得以保护 to obtain protection. 得以保存下来 to be preserved over a length of time. So we would say,It's only thanks to the Naxi people that this music was preserved. Okay, let's watch this dialogue now and learn a little bit more about 纳西古乐。
好，我在美国看过一些有关纳西古乐的介绍，听说很多听过纳西古乐的人呀，都被他所感动。
我对纳西古乐也非常感兴趣，只要有时间，我就去听纳西古乐。今天我就要去。哎，如果你们有兴趣的话。咱们过一会儿一起去吧。
啊，太好了，我们一定去。据说纳西古乐原来是一种道教音乐啊。
对，是明朝时从中原地区传入的，后来又加入了纳西风格，形成了纳西古乐。
你看啊，这种音乐啊，在内地已经没有了，哎，反倒在丽江地区一直流传了下来。你说这是为什么呀？
我听说就是因为纳西族女人。向来很勤劳能干，帮完了家里所有的工作，纳西族男人才有时间去研究纳西古乐。
这种看法倒挺新鲜的，不过无论原因是什么，都多亏了纳西族人，才使得这古老的音乐得以保存下来。
哎，这种音乐会每天都有吗？
每天晚上都有，乐师们都是纳西古乐的爱好者和研究者，雷打不动，每天都会来演奏。哎，时间不早了，咱们走吧。
好好好，走好。
From Lijiang in Yunnan, we skip now to Shandong province in eastern China, where Xue Mei is traveling with a colleague. They're climbing up Taishan, which is considered first among the holy mountains of China. It's quite a tiring walk up the mountain. Here we talked a bit about the pattern of a verb followed by 不动to show that the action can't be completed or can't be sustained. 爬不动, can't climb any further. 跑不动, can't run anymore. There are several gates along the way called 天门 or gate to heaven. For instance, there's the 一天门, first gate to heaven, at the foot of the mountain. 山脚, this is just like we say in English, the foot of a mountain, 山脚. Now at the top of the mountain, 山顶, there's another gate, that's the 南天门, the south gate to heaven.There are many interesting sights along the way as well, like this famous pine tree with the unique name of 五大夫松. Now, 大夫 is doctor, so one might assume that this tree for some reason has been called doctor, but actually here the name refers to an ancient title, 大夫, which was the name of a 官职, an official's position in ancient China. Now, this is not an ordinary tree, and it's not a doctor either. It's 相当于当官的人, the equivalent of a government official.相当于 means the same as, equal to, or the equivalent of. Now, how did this tree become a government official? Well, the story goes that it was appointed by the first emperor of China, Qin Shi Huang, himself. The story goes that when Qin Shi Huang, the first emperor, visited Taishan, 谁知突然下起了大雨? Who would have known but it suddenly started to rain heavily? 谁知 who knows, or who could have known? It was very unexpected.The first emperor hid under the pine tree and was not soaked in the rain. 没有被淋湿. He was so grateful to the tree that he gave it an official title, granted it a position of honor. Okay, let's check out that story.
雪梅，我们休息一会儿再爬吧，我有点爬不动了。你呢，累吗？
我还好。我在北京的时候，我就经常跟我老公一起去爬香山。
是吗？怪不得你刚才走得飞快呢。不过泰山可比香山高多了。
而且我还听说中国历史上的很多名人都爬过泰山呢。哎，你说我们现在离山顶有多远呢？
我也不知道。
不过刚才我听别人说，前面马上就是泰山的中天门了，大概爬了有一半了吧。
真的吗？那我们就别休息了吧，一鼓作气爬上去吧。
好吧。中天门，中天门，哎，刚才我们在山脚的时候看到一个一天门。
一天门？ 中天门，这个天门指的意思是不是可以一直通到天上的门呢？
嗯，我觉得古人可能觉得这座山太高了，和天都连着呢。
今天我倒要看看这座通天的山到底有多高。小李，咱们走吧。古代古松，小李，你看这几棵松树还是大夫呢。
这可不读大夫，要读大夫。
是吗？难道这不是医生的意思吗？以前我老把这个字的音读错。
这里可不是医生的意思，武大夫在古代是一个官职的名称，这松树呢也不是医生，不过却相当于当官的人。
哈，这可真有创意。可是谁会让松树来当官呢？
秦始皇啊。
是吗？他也来过泰山吗？
对，有一次他到泰山来祭天，谁知突然下起了大雨，他正好躲在松树下，没有被淋湿。后来为了感谢这棵松树，就封他为武大夫松。
孔子是中国历史上的第一位老师。 Confucius is considered the first Chinese teacher, the first teacher in Chinese history. The main literary works that outlined the principles of Confucianism, like the Analects, 论语, were actually written by the pupils of Confucius, not by the master himself. The place we're visiting today 是专门为了纪念他而修建的, was built specifically in remembrance of him.专门为 something 而做的 is made specially for something. 专门为纪念 somebody 而修建的 made specially to remember somebody or in remembrance of somebody. This is the 孔庙, the Confucian temple. Actually, there are many Confucian temples across China, but Qufu in Shandong was the hometown of Confucius, 孔子的故乡. Here, besides the temple, you could also visit the 孔府Confucian family mansion and the Confucian cemetery, where over 70 generations of the Kong family are buried. Okay, let's go back through that dialogue again.
我上大学的时候，我读过《论语》里的文章。据说孔子是中国历史上的第一位老师，是这样吗？
对，我们都这么说。早在2500多年以前，孔子就是一位特别出色的老师了。尤其是他的思想对中国的文化影响很大，所以中国人都特别尊敬他。
几位，你看，这就是杏坛。杏坛，这是什么地方？
杏坛是当年孔子讲学的地方。
讲学的地方，我看这里坐不下几个学生，可不是有弟子三千吗？
雪梅，这你可不知道了。这个杏坛呀，是宋朝人专门为纪念孔子而修建的。当时孔子就坐在这个地方，边抚琴边讲课，他的学生呢围坐在他的周围听他上课。
哦，是这样。
雪梅，你猜这是什么地方？
我看这个院子里有好多鸟。这个会不会是一个美国式的 bird bath？
你真有想象力。不过这儿可不是让鸟洗澡的地方。现在人们听到铃声呢，就会下课。在春秋时候呢，孔子在这里燃上三炷香，等香烧尽了，也就是下课的时间了。
这个办法可真聪明啊！
锦梅，我现在带你去大成殿看看吧。
大成殿？
对呀，大成殿是每年人们烧香祭奠孔子的地方。
那我们也赶紧烧一炷香纪念一下孔老师吧。
好主意，走。
That brings us to the end of today's review lesson. I hope you were able to pick up more material when we went over the things again. Well, in the next episode, we're going to start with some new material. Xue Mei is going to Suzhou, and we're going to explore in some detail the gardens of Suzhou, some of the best classical gardens in China. Suzhou is a major production center for silk, Sichou. So make sure you don't miss that episode. We'll see you here back on Travel in Chinese. 再见.